Hello friend, welcome to StackPhy, and if you help me to solve today's physics problem till the end of the video, then you get a cookie. So let's go. Guess what? The answer key provided for this particular question in the book is wrong. If only I could get a dollar for every time I find all these mistakes in answer keys and questions in all these books, then I would be able to buy myself a new pair of shoes. I think I should sell my old shoes to Kachra Set. I hope he gives me more than their 100 rupiah. Anyways, so let us come to our today's question. Three identical heaters are installed in a chamber that is made of heat insulating walls and is open at one side. The open side is covered with a heat conducting membrane as shown in figure 1. So this is the open side, which is covered with a membrane. Outside temperature is 10 degrees centigrade. If all the heaters are switched on, steady state temperature inside the chamber becomes 25 degrees centigrade. If two more membranes that are similar to the first one were placed between the heaters as shown in figure 2, what would be the steady state temperatures of parts A, B and C? So let's come to our solution. So in the initial one, when the whole structure is covered with insulating walls from all the side except this one, so this is a heat conducting membrane. When all these three heaters are turned on simultaneously, each heater emits same amount of heat per unit time. Okay, let Q be the amount of heat emitted by each heater per unit time. Anyways, the total heat emitted should be equal to the total heat created per unit time. Then only you can achieve a steady state, right? So per unit time, 3Q amount of heat should come out from this chamber. They have already provided that the temperature inside the chamber is 25 and outer temperature is 10. So heat radiated or heat coming out is directly proportional to the temperature difference. So that gives you Q, that's the energy radiated by each radiator, is directly proportional to 5. Of course, there should be some proportionality constant. I won't take that one for the time being. In our second situation, these three heaters are separated by this two additional membranes. Okay, so at steady temperature we need to find out the temperature of each chamber. Okay, now see, if the temperature of this chamber needs to be in a steady state at a fixed temperature, then the heat created inside this temperature should be equal to the heat sending away from this chamber. Okay, so what is the heat being created here? The heat being created is Q. So Q amount of heat should go out from this chamber, right? So that heat going out from chamber A to chamber B, that is Q, should be directly proportional to TA, the difference between the temperatures of these two chambers, right? Similarly, in this chamber, Q amount of heat is coming from chamber A. Q amount of heat is created by the chamber B, the radiator B itself. That means influx of heat is 2Q. So equal amount of heat should go to the chamber C away from chamber B, right? So 2Q amount of heat is being pushed from B to C, which is directly proportional to the temperature difference. Similarly, amount of heat of influx is 3Q. So the outflux should also be 3Q to maintain a stable situation. So 3Q is directly proportional to the difference of TC and 10. Okay, so we get all these equations. And initially we have already found that Q is directly proportional to 5. So from here we can write TC minus 10 equals to 3 times 5. Of course that proportionality constant will get cancelled out. So here it is 15. So TC is 25 degree centigrade. Anyways, so TB minus TC is twice of Q, that is twice of 5, 10. We already got TC, so TB is 35 degrees centigrade. So temperature of chamber B at stable situation is 35 degrees centigrade. Similarly, we can use this one. So TA minus TB, okay, equals 5. How? Because Q, and Q is directly proportional to 5. And that proportionality constant will get cancelled out. Simple. So from there we can get TA equals 45 degrees centigrade. right? So I hope you all have found this video helpful and informative. If you are new to this channel, you should hit the subscribe button, and as you have come to the end of the video, you get a cookie. So I'll see you in the next one. Peace, take care.